In today's class, we discuss about one more connective tissue. It is a blood. Let us select this highlighter. So, connective tissues we have been discussing here. Muscle is a connective tissue. Bone is a connective tissue. Ligament is a connective tissue. Tendon is a connective tissue. Cartilage is a connective tissue. Along with that, one more tissue is there. It is blood. Blood is most important here. Why? Because almost each and every part of our body is connected with the blood. Wherever you scrap our body, blood will be coming out. So maximum 99% of our body parts is filled with blood. So usually at your age, 5 liters of blood will be there. But in case of adult, 5.5 liters of blood. So adult means here at normal weight and height, you need to think. Understood? For example, if a person is having 5.8 height, 5 feet 8 inches height, and his weight is 70 kg, so that kind of person, normal weight and normal height, 5.5 liters of blood will be present, and that is the average blood type. And this may increase or decrease depending upon the person's height or weight, or depending upon the person's height and weight. And what is the important thing here? Blood will be making the identity of a wellness and illness. That means here, whenever you want to be healthy, then your blood will supply good nutrients to your body. And during your illness, your blood will supply policemen to kill the microorganisms that caused you illness. So in this perspective here, blood is a connective tissue. Blood connects each and every part of our body. And one more thing here, there are nearly 36,000 liters of blood will be transported by heart every 24 hours of a day. That means here, nearly a distance of 20,000 kilometers. So if we discuss about how many liters it transports and heart transports, and how many kilometers it will transport, if we calculate, means here 20,000 kilometers per a day it will transport. And how many liters here? 36,000 liters of blood will be transported from the heart. So you must thank your heart for pumping these many liters of blood per day without causing any disturbance. So in this flow, if any disturbances are there, then the body will be instability. That means it becomes into instability. And can we say that all organisms having blood are our relatives? All organisms having blood in a red in color, they are our relatives. But here is one exception is there. So what is that exception? You can see already I have highlighted, cockroach will have white color blood. Why? Because in that hemoglobin is absent. Hemoglobin is an iron compound pigment which gives blood into red color. In cockroach this is absent. Iron is absent in cockroach. Understood? So that only in China, cockroaches also will be eaten. Understood? So they will be taking all the organisms here. So iron will be getting naturally. So cockroach will also be taken. So they can get a very less iron there. And also if you see in a snail, blue color blood we can see. In that also pigment hemoglobin is absent. So that only color change will be seen. And what other things are there in the blood here? Other things are there in the blood is glucose, which is a chief element we will discuss in a 10th class. And amino acids, when you just take chicken and mutton, this will be getting. This when you take rice, this enters into blood. And after that proteins, when you take dal, meat, eggs, fish. So these all you will be getting proteins. Vitamins also important. You will be taking vegetables and non-vegetables, fruits. So from that we'll be getting. Now hormones also. Hormones are due to adolescent age. You are in now adolescent age. Congratulations for getting into adolescent age. And now hormones will be developed. Growth hormone is important. Growth hormone is most important. That is released through thyroid gland. So near your neck here. So that only you are supposed to eat in this age. Fish, eggs are needed to eat. Eggs at least monthly you need to eat. And monthly, that means per week you can eat 5 to 6 eggs or if you incorporate one egg per day, that is even better. Fish weekly once you need to allot the time. Why? Because this is your body and that is your health. So if you eat from 13 years to 19 years fish per week, so you will be getting a high health, high hygiene without any thyroid problems. Even though now also if you are getting any thyroid problems, means you can also make sure that you are supposed to eat fish, or in a market, in online, you will be getting walnut oil. Walnut oil, nearly 100 ml will be there, tonic bottle size, 300 rupees will be there. That you need to apply for your throat region. Your throat region will be there, no? There you need to apply during your sleep. Due to that, thyroid problem will be gone. Why? Because hormones are important for our body to function properly. And if we discuss about what are present in the blood. So, three things are present in the blood here. RBC, WBC and platelets. RBC, WBC and platelets are there. RBC cells are red in color. And WBC cells don't have any color. So that they are called as leukocytes. RBCs are called as erythrocytes. RBCs are called as erythrocytes. Platelets, after dissolution, for example, if you collect a blood in the glass, half of the glass, come after 1 hour, then what will happen here? Water material will be there here and solid material will be there here. This solid material is RBC and platelets. This transparent liquid is called as WBC. That means, to explain properly here, blood, if you just collect in a glass and after 1 hour you just come, then it solidifies here. This solidifies consists of RBCs and platelets, and this consists of WBCs. This is a water liquid like a material here, so it consists of WBCs. Understood? RBCs are called as erythrocytes. WBCs are called as leukocytes. Leuko means here colorless. Understood? So erythrocytes are called as RBCs, red blood cells, or corpuscles, white blood corpuscles. So two things are there, blood platelets also. In that, blood platelets will be there. So what are the, what is the use of these three things here? Usually RBC will be having red in color. Why? Because in that hemoglobin is present. So this hemoglobin will help us to absorb oxygen. And blood will be produced for every 120 days. That means in a year, three times your new blood will be formed. Understood? Remember, this will be most important here. Blood will be prepared within 120 days. So in a year, three times your blood will be made. So your old, that means by birth, your blood, if you think that from the birth time you have the same blood, means that is utterly wrong. Your blood has been purified many times, many times, many times, many times. Understood? Per year, three times your blood will be purified here. And one more thing here, 5 million RBCs will be there in our body. That you need to remember. These 5 million cells, if we just make in a line, we can swirl this earth nearly 7 times. 7 times we can round with that cells. If we link one after other, then we can round our earth 7 times. Understood? So this no one will ask in your exam, but remember, 120 days period your blood will be formed. That is important. And one more thing here, during when you are there in the stomach of the mother, your liver and spleen part will be there, that produces blood. And the day when you come out from your mother, delivery day, then bone marrow will be there. Bone marrow means here our thigh region will be there. So our thigh region, this thigh region will be there. From here blood will be formed. Understood? Bone marrow. So that only some people will be eating this meat bone inside bone marrow. Some people will like that bone marrow. So from there will be there. Now we will be getting blood from our bone marrow only. But when we were in the mother's body, liver and spleen will be producing our RBCs. Understood? And one more thing here to discuss about the classification of this thing. Cells, if you just think about blood cells classification, RBCs will be there and WBCs will be there. WBCs are further categorized into, here I am making, RBCs there is no classification. Nucleus will be there and the cell, erythrocytes, they are called as erythrocytes. classes are most important here. Without wasting a time, you need to listen the classes. Even though school starts also, classes will be going on in your school also and in the online also. So school you need to listen, school there only, and online classes you need to listen online only. Why? Because it is a regular repetition of your knowledge. If I teach, means my knowledge only will increase. If you listen, your knowledge also will be increased. Understood? And WBC classification to discuss here. Two types of the are there: granulocytes and agranulocytes. So granulocytes again divided into three types: basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils. Agranulocytes is further divided into two types here. First is monocytes, for example, monocytes. Next one it is lymphocytes. Monocytes, lymphocytes. Granulocytes means here, in these types of cells, some granules are present. But here, granules are not present, empty. Both having nucleus types, like this. Understood? So this is about WBC classification. WBC classification is important here. Two types are there: granulocytes and agranulocytes. First one it is in granulocytes, basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils. In agranulocytes, monocytes and lymphocytes. Understood? So this is the classification. So what is the important of WBCs? RBCs you know very well, only one function. Whatever a food we eat, that will transport to the body, and oxygen, it will transport to the body. These two functions only maximum. But WBC function is different. WBC function is that they act like a microscopic policeman. That means any microorganism entered into our body, it will recognize and it will kill it. So during injury, for example, you got some injury. During this injury, what will happen? It will be curing with WBC cells. After that, you will be seeing yellow color pus. Yellow color pus, if you are getting, means there a big war happened between our WBC cells and foreign waste fellows. That means microorganisms. A big war happened and we only have won. WBCs have won that war. Understood? Wherever pus you are getting, some members will be getting pus from ears. Some members will be getting pus from the leg injury, hand injury. So if it is getting, means you need to think that it is getting, that means we have won that war. Understood? So that is the thing here. That's why they are called as microscopic policemen. And also two types are there here, monocytes and lymphocytes here. In that granulocytes we discussed, WBC's classification is there. In WBC classification, granulocytes, agranulocytes are there. Granulocytes will fight against different kinds of microorganisms that are entering to our body. But agranulocytes will attack directly. Attack, and they will kill also sometimes. Sometimes what will happen during this killing of microorganism, WBC cells also will die itself in that war. That's why they are very, very great. And they are otherwise called as scavengers. WBCs are otherwise called as scavenger and are called as microscopic policemen. These terms, even if you enter into BPC or doctor or any field, even normally also you need know biology about your body only. Even if you take arts or otherwise, if you take MPC or any CEC, HEC, engineering, so every field having a knowledge on your body is important. So biology is not due to subject. If you read, means it cannot get. It is, you need to feel that it is your body itself. Understood? So WBCs are called as scavengers and otherwise called as policemen. Which policemen? Microscopic policemen. These two names are there here for it. And next one, third type, it is the blood platelets. Blood platelets. We discussed about in a class of blood. If you just put 1 hour, solid material is called as RBC and platelets, and this one is called as liquid is called as WBC. So So these platelets are important to clot the blood. For example, a small blood injury has occurred for you. So your blood is oozing out. So due to that oozing out, after 1 minute or 2 minute or 3 minute, your blood stops moving and it becomes black color. And after 2 to 3 days, even the skin becomes very black. So that is due to platelets. Platelets will stop blood flow going outside unnecessarily. It is like a gateway of our body. Understood? Not India gate. It is gateway of our body. Blood will be moving out, means this platelet will stop going out our valuable blood. And can you wonder that all your own sisters and your own brothers are not your relatives? Can you believe this? But it is true. They are not your relatives. In which perspective? In blood perspective. So what is the thing here? Karl Landsteiner was a scientist. He was a German scientist here. And he later became a doctor also. He introduced a type called as blood grouping system. Who introduced that? Karl Landsteiner, German doctor. So he introduced blood group system and he found that ABO blood groups. He only said that first time. That means our blood groups are not same. Our blood groups are not same. We will be having 4 different kinds of blood groups. A blood group, B blood group, AB blood group and O blood group. He only said 4 blood groups. Later, due to science and technology, blood group types have been discovered. Blood group types means here, for every blood group, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. So 8 blood group types will be there. Blood groups are 4. Blood group types are 8. Understood? And in this O blood group is known as universal donor. And AB blood group is known as universal recipient. Understood? Recipient. So what is that universal donor? What is that universal receptor? Why they discovered that? And who was Karl Landsteiner? These all surprising things we will discuss in the next coming class. This is all for today. Have a good day ahead.